Hi, my dear lovely Aries. Welcome to your predictions for your June taroscope for everybody whose sign is an Aries, the rising sun or ascendant or the moon sign. So it's worth it to watch the other videos also to all your other signs. And then you got a rounder picture. At least. If you got questions, I also do personal readings, but I'm gonna say that at least at the end of the video. So, I'm doing my videos from Zurich, from Switzerland now, and it's very cold outside, so it's not even spring, it's like kinda autumn weather, and I thought like I just do hear some fire energy inside, and I hope that you can hear the burning wood in the background, actually. So well, a very cozy fire space for us today. So we got all the topics which are for the most of the people quite interesting. We got here three things going around. So first we actually have here the predictions from the 1st to the 10th of June 2016, then from the 10th to the 20th of June, and then the end of the month. And the first question is here, what's going on? So how are you physically and emotionally? It's like the question of health for a tendency for everybody who's watching here. So this is a very general forecast, and this is now here the 13, so it means like it's standing here freedom. So these are the German cards, you know, so it's like the deck of Dorian Virtue, the angel tarot deck. And I'm actually a German originally, so I got them here written in German, but that doesn't matter. So that means transformation. It could be that something is just going to an end. Maybe it's just something very simple that you just cut your monthly thing, what you had done, like for fitness or something like that, or you know, you just stop doing something in regards to your health. It can be that you just stop smoking. It could be that you just stop to be addicted to something or any other bad things that are related or could be related to your health, you know. There is just a shift, just an end of something. Then we have here your workplace and your finances. So we got here an atmosphere of conflict, it could be. Maybe you got new structures on your workplace, or just conflicts, or just discussions with clients, with people in your work's area, something like that. And these are just really discussions that have to be made. Maybe there are conflicts in interests or something like that also, but you know, it's very rational, and it's really the tip here to calm down, even if your emotions are really cooking up. So it's like when you're calm and you just get straight to the point, you know, without being too emotional, so that discussion will be good. And there are a lot of people involved, but I'm just gonna say something about that later. So this is just the thing that's going on from the 1st to the 10th. Okay, we got here everything that you just do, not so so long. Like your work. I mean, this can be something creative, that could be also just your little job that you do aside, some hours work somewhere, or just painting your picture or anything like that. And here is like saying this thing that you're thinking of or that you're doing is not so important for you. It's maybe like a course that you just join in, any painting or anything, like singing lessons or just some sports, but it's not necessary for you, you know. Okay, and the love, oh my gosh, so we got here, the people are not so committing, I see. Maybe you're not committing and you're just like flirting around, or maybe cheating a little or something, or other people are just like that. So everybody who's searching for a partner, That could be quite difficult in the 10 month. Just, you know, check out very clearly who's in your surrounding. All right, so we got here actually the people who are in your surrounding. So that can be everybody. It could be your family members. That could be your friends. It could be just everybody that surrounds you. And the people, you know, that's like the card of the original tarot is the Fool. And the Fool, you know, it says just like that. The Fool. I just don't need to explain it. Maybe they are very young persons. Or just, you know, in the mind, very young persons. And they are more adventurous than any committed or anything like that. So they are not very much like responsible. No responsibility from this person's, please. But if you just want to enjoy your life, hang around with children or with young people, the young persons, you can do that. But, you know, big responsibilities or commitments, if you see at your love life here, you will not find it in the first 10 days. Okay? But, you know, we are more than our sign only. So, it's also interesting to check out your rising sun and your moon sign and whatever. These are only tendencies here for everybody. And we got here from the 10th to the 20th of June, my dears. How are you, 9 Gabriel? Oh my gosh. So, you are like afraid that somebody's hurting you, maybe in a physical sense, or you are just not trusting to any health issues or any healings or therapy or stuff like that, and you're just doubting, and you know, you're not trusting the people or just the things around you. That's what I see. Maybe you're also so afraid that you don't let anybody to your heart, inside your heart, and so on. You're just like closed. Maybe we need a time like that too. I mean, my gosh. Maybe you can use it for any meditation or just to get clear what you want and to heal from that here, maybe. Maybe it hurts you. You know, if you are just a very adventurous Aries who doesn't need any kind of a relationship right now, this is no problem. But for everybody else, it could be. Or it might be. So, and we got here at the workplace. So, the conflicts are done here. Because we got here persons. So, we got the Queen of Gabriel. So, she's like a very fiery, lot of passion she has. She's very wild in a way. So, she knows exactly what she wants. And she knows how to get it. And but she's really acting from the heart. You know, so it's like really a woman here on the card. And yeah, it's like feminine energy, and feminine energy is like from the heart. So she got really high ideals, but she's really fighting for them too, you know. So maybe old structures can be just redone here. Maybe the discussions are about these structures and things which are old and which are not bringing the firm or the project or wherever you are working not to the point, and it has to be changed. And she is really like the fighter for it. Maybe a person like that comes into your workplace, or you becoming that, and your transformation here is becoming to this queen, and you're like very powerful, and they like that. Okay, so we got here your things that you do aside, creative projects or any little work that you are doing, but it's not so much your big profession. But these two areas can come together. So everybody who's just like is doing a profession which is also the hobby, of course, it's really matching nice together here. And the interesting thing is there is that could be here a person, a young person, a student maybe, or somebody who's very responsible, who knows that if he or she's studying right now, they will be very successful in the future. So these are very young and responsible people, but that can be also somebody who's older, but really have actually is still learning something, always learning something, you know. So that could be that you are the person who is doing something creative or anything, but it's on a level like from a student. It's not that big talent thing. I'm sorry for that. You know, but if you want to earn some money, there is little money. You know, it's also like student money somehow. We are not talking here about the big resources. We don't do that. But this could be an indicator that you do something with your hands, or just something that you see a result after. All right. And we go further, the love. Oh my gosh, so this is really like very tricky, because the persons, or you yourself, you are like it's like an energy of a fish, and just catch a fish, the fish is like slipping away, and there are very lot of people there surrounding, and you feel like fighting. If you want to fight for somebody because you're in love, there could be a lot of other people around who also wants this person. Yeah, something like this, just a conflict like that. You can win the situation, but come on, it's just like a lot of fight. I mean, maybe it's a very great person, I don't know. Or somebody is fighting for you in a way, but phew, it's like just too much for you. I see. It's too much, this five wand thing. So, if you really want, yeah, my gosh. But, you know, the price is high. I mean, it's like, okay, you know, to fight for somebody, I agree. It's okay if you really feel something for somebody. But I think, like, it's better when this person also is committing and also feels the same. That's my opinion. It's just my personal opinion. But it's the tendency of all Aries, and you guys must know what to do for yourself. Alright, so we got here the people that surrounds you, and these are like, oh my gosh, quite conflictful people, maybe cheaters, maybe even criminals, I'm sorry, oh my god. No, it's not everybody, you know, that's like, these are tendencies, and there could be some people who have these tendencies. The point is only, check really out with whom you are here related. So, who is in your surrounding? Who is fighting? These are five swords and five wands. Gosh, this is a big conflict maybe in relationships. So please look at that. And don't go too deep inside of this. I wouldn't. If you have any questions, you can always call me. Not call me, but you can write me an email. So like that, first an email with your question, you know. So I do personal readings as well. And check out your sign and your moon sign, so, you know, it's maybe not so bad like standing here. And now we have the end of the month, so we have, how are you? 8 Michael. well, this is really not so nice. So actually, you feel like not want to get hurt again. And here, you feel maybe depressed, not so well. And emotionally very, very stressed. And you actually would like to have a certain situation, but it's not there. And it's better to accept it than fight too much. I would suggest that. Or just, you know, go to a therapy. Just ask somebody for help, for anything. And I don't know, you know, or write me an email or something. It's always everything better than just to stuck into this these feelings there. In your work area, the King Raphael. Yeah, he's cool, you know. Even if he's at your work, these are very emotional, very social people. There could be therapists, there could be any kind of psychologists, you know, very spiritual people maybe in a social jobs in a way, social therapists, whatever, and artists very often, artists. It could be that even if he's your boss or even just a client, you could even talk to him about all that shit. He would understand. You know, the best persons, we don't know where we meet them. Give the life a chance to bring you the right persons. And he is very cool. Maybe he's just like feeling how you're doing. And helping you. Maybe he's like saying when he's your boss, like, hey, come on, gosh, go home. If he's a really cool boss, you know, because just grab some help. Yeah. So maybe somebody is at your work area, or you feel very creative at your work. That could be also. Okay, Aries, and now really look at this.
And I'm not kidding, I just made I took an extra card and here is like five Ariel. So I'm gonna translate that because these cards are in German language. And it's literally standing here, and I'm not lying to you. You don't need to carry everything on your own shoulders and don't do everything alone. Help is nearby or just there where you are already. It's really standing here. And don't think negative, think always positive. Always positive thinking. And just think like the good things are just coming to you into your body. This is a manifestation I love to do. Like, I want something, and the energy of that, the positive, is like air coming to my body. And it works so often. So really, I hug you, I kiss you, and just don't worry, it's only a month. I mean, the energies are not so easy here for you, I must really say that, but yeah, help is really in the near, how to say. You don't say it in English, you just say it differently, right? But there are people around you that can help you very good. The rest is just depending on your other signs and your under different places, of course. Yeah, so not for everybody is this really this very weird thing. It's very different for everybody. But you know, I just love the cards for that because they are just talking so clearly to us so often. And this is literally the thing that I saw, like here, that these two persons, they could be just your helpers. And here, bam, you can have help. Yeah. Just this very nice moments with tarot cards I always have so often. And I'm so thankful for it because it's such a good help. They are like friends, I think. Okay, and in your hobby or everything that you just do aside, well, I must say here the project was not so important for you, right? And here you did it like half thing doing or just beginner style, and there it's just coming to an end. Yeah, it could be just your fitness contract or whatever or anything that you did as a hobby. It can stop. Or just something you just did aside. Okay, so here we go. Just to this point, I just have it here also because for some people that could be actually something that comes from a hobby, and it could be even a profession in your life. So you know, like something that you really love to do but just don't dare yet and stuff like that, because very often it's like there's a workplace and the creative area here or something that we just do some few hours or so can be relate very well together. So that's why I just did these things here. If it's just a little hobby for somebody, that's also okay, you know. But then it's not so it doesn't have so much weight on that then. This prediction. Okay, and in cases of love, oh my gosh. So really a burden falls out of my heart when I see that, because you can see those two horses, one is white, though the other one is black, so they cannot be different, but they go into the same direction. So you actually have the chance really in this month, you know, and that's why these conflicts are. You get some help from somebody, you feel depressed in the middle and in the end, but you have the chance really to look at the issues and really find a solution for these conflicts, because this is a conflict. So you know, two souls are in my breast. You know, sometimes I'm just translating German stuff into the English, so I don't know if everybody understands me then. But you know, it's like black and white into yourself, like the twin or so. And that brings a conflict, and we manifest the wrong stuff when we just have two different wishes. But to really get conscious about that, what you want, or what you know, different types of your or parts of your personality actually want, to bring that together, this is mastering. If you learn that once, you will always have that. So be just grateful and thank you for all the shit here, because other people that really doesn't have don't have the chance to do that. They will not learn it. This is really a chance. And these guys here, the König Raphael, King Raphael and so, that guy is diving deep. Let's see, you know, this is water. I mean, normally they are just like described of this creative persons, whatever. But they are also very often psychotherapists and so. But you know, it's not like this going to a psychotherapist is like, you are crazy. It's not the... this is not the case. It's like the conflict is a present, so you can really see through that then. And when you dare to really dive into this deep, this is a great thing for you. See it as positive as it actually can be when we work it out. And look, I mean, what is that when you are able at least to really bring those two differences into one direction? And you know who this person is. This is you, my dear. And look at the smile. You know, just remember the smile that will be at the end of the rainbow when you go through this, even if it doesn't happen at first place. Even this is just the trophy that you will get in the end. My gosh. Okay, the people that surrounds you, oh my god. So actually they feel like overwhelming. They just feel overwhelming. Maybe they have the same conflict and just go through that also. Maybe you just go through pain and suffering with this person. Or maybe not, you know? I mean, here's actually the sign that... yeah, I mean, it could be that you actually come together with a partner, or you just come together with yourself, and then in the second step, you will come together with a partner, okay? And these partners are also suffering and going through something. Or family, or just friends, you know? First, they're like feeling like they just don't care. And then they like making conflicts and just really, really doesn't want to deal with conflicts. And then here they actually are overwhelming of that, okay? But it can be good. I mean, when you move forward, what shall they do then? Maybe you just also get out of a toxic relationship. And the positive thing can be here also that you get out of this. You're strong enough then. Okay, my lovely, lovely Aries soul. well, I hope that this month will be a great one. I really hope that. And we're always learning out of that stuff. So, I love you all and thank you for watching, for subscribing, for liking the videos and for all that. And I hope that you keep on watching. And if you want to have some help, if I'm the one that can help you, you can just write me an email. The email address is standing below. And anyhow, I wish you the best month ever and hope you find the right person and so on. And yeah, bye-bye.